Welcome back for part two of Turtle Beach, Caspersen Beach. Thanks for coming back to check out the rest of the cool identifications and see all the fun things that got made. Pick up right where we left off, jump right back into those shell IDs.
All right, now let's talk about Caspersen Beach. Like I said, Caspersen is known for shark's teeth, and I don't even have everything I found on that trip on this table. I just don't even have room. But what a variety of stuff that day. I mean, gosh, can't even believe it. Let's get started up here. More of our buddies, the mossy arcs. I don't know why I like these so much. They're just a weird, goofy looking, like a foot almost. But I don't know, something about the shape on them, I just think they're so cool. And these guys here are their cousins, the turkey wings. That one even has some coral on it. Then we get over into the calico scallops. And we have some rough scallops as well in there. This one here is a rough. This guy. Actually, nope. That one is not. That one's actually a baby bay. My bad. And here we have three pieces, which is amazing. Three pieces of lion's paw. We never find them whole here, number one. We rarely find pieces here, number two. So to have three of them in one stop, that was pretty awesome. And a big old fossil oyster up here. Some kind of crazy fishing lure. Some of those calico clams, prickly cockles, buttercup lucines, some little broad rib carditas. There's a coquina in there. Another painted egg cockle here, here, and here. This is an Atlantic bittersweet. We don't find those here either. Those are typically an East Coast, not a West Coast shell. So that was a very unusual find that day as well. I have to think the hurricanes might have rearranged a few things and brought things into the Gulf that we don't normally see. Because that's astonishing to see that here. Here's a baby version of it too. And then that one's a comb bittersweet, a different version of a bittersweet. And as you can see over here, got a teeny tiny little horse conchs. That's like a proto shell, that one. It's so little. Barnacle, might be a fossilized top off an olive. Couple of moon snails, that nice Paul Newman blue in the middle, love that. Look at the limpets. These guys, I call them my good luck shells. I just adore them. Usually you find a couple in a trip, not a fistful of them, so that was pretty unusual for that, to find so many in one place. We have also some zigzag flat pieces, a broken and a whole one, another rare find for our area. Up here we have surf clams, a nice big egg cockle, the talon shell, and I think I was calling these little guys crassatellas. In fossil world, this shape is a beautiful crassatella, but in modern shells, these guys are pointed Venus clams. Aren't they darling? I just love their little points on them. They're so cute. This, not a clue. Some kind of strange coral, maybe a fossilized version of one. No idea what that is. So I will try to dig into that a little further. Just some regular quahogs. All right, here are our white Atlantic semiles here. And these are cancellate semiles or purplish semiles, depending on the colors on them. They have that ovaly shape to them, unlike these guys, which are rounder. But these all look like they're from the purplish family, even though they're not quite all purple. Some of them can be orange, some of them will be brown. So those were kind of a cool find. This was also a cool find. This is a strawberry cockle. Now, I know I get the yellows all the time, but look at the difference in the shape. With that flat and that point to it, that is a strawberry cockle, a small one. and a rare find for this area as well. This is the only one I have in my collection, actually. So that was a super cool find. Then over here, we got some Seraphs and some Turbos and some Augers. And then this guy, he's not ridged like the others, although his colors are similar. This is what they call a smooth auger. Again, not a shell that we find very often here. And these guys pretend they look like they're Wentel traps, but they're not. They're just little Seraphs, these little guys here. But they're super adorable, cute, tiny. I just like these so much, these little ones. So yeah, I found an astonishing amount of stuff to work with. Up here we have in the pieces and parts department some old crown conchs, broken murex, worm snail, some nice big olive here, and this is a piece off of a true tulip, and a monster true tulip. If that shell was whole, it'd be about this big. Absolutely huge. So as a shell, it's not great. But as an example of how big they get, it's cool. And this is actually going to get cut up and made into earrings. So I guess I'll start looking and start picking out some things that I'm going to make some stuff with. And before I pick everything out, I want to talk a little bit about how do I figure out what these shells are. This is my favorite book. This is called Florida's Living Beaches by Blair and Dawn Witherington. And it has almost everything that you would find on the beach in it. Now, as I turn this book sideways, you'll tell what section I'm in. Where the book looks dirty, that's where the shells are. So that's where I thumb through all the time. But they have more in here than that. Talk about different weird things you might find on the beach. Fossil shells you might find at the beach. Types of seeds and pods you would find. Animal life, birds, turtles, fish, all kinds of nifty stuff. But my favorite section is up here. And what they do is they give you pictures, examples of the shells, and they show you up here where they're found. So if you see something here that has a solid purple line, sunray Venus clams and calico clams, very common for all of the Gulf Coast of Florida on the west side. But things like Princess Venus clams, not so much. More rare here. More of a southern and Keys kind of a thing. And they tell you about the habitat, about sizes, color variations, all sorts of stuff. This is my very favorite book. And there are those adorable little Venus clams. So I just want to say thank you to the Witheringtons, because I can't tell you how much I've learned from this book. This book is amazing. And there's our similes we were talking about. Here's our white Atlantic simile, even with the purplish colors inside. The cancelets, which are more white. And then these guys, the purplish, which would be purple or orange or brown. I spend hours, I mean literally hours, just looking at this book and figuring things out and figuring out where can I go find a certain shell, like all that sort of stuff. So this is amazing, this book. I just absolutely love this. I don't get paid anything. I'm not a sponsored by them. I don't make any money if you go buy this book. I'm not an affiliate. I just think as far as education purposes go, just to tell you who makes it, it's Pineapple Press out of Sarasota, Florida. And when I got it, it was $23. And that's what the spine looks like. So if you are a beachcomber in Florida and you're trying to figure out some of these fun things you're finding, this book will teach you literally tons. And I don't think it's the only book they have either. I think they have other areas too. So it's worth looking online for it. Alrighty. So a lot of this stuff is a little on the smallish side. As you can tell, I got a lot of little micro shells this day. And I, you know, when I left Turtle Beach, I was kind of frustrated. I didn't find very much other than this little gem, which I was super happy about, but I didn't find a lot of things that I could make stuff with. What I am glad of is that I did find this guy, though. All right, so here's an auger. Oh, well, it's not a great auger to show. All right, hang on a second. Let's see. This guy. This is just a common auger. And you can see what their little opening looks like. And then let's take a look at the turret snail. Flat on the bottom. Just flat on the bottom. So that is the difference. I mean, the color is a little different too. The shapes are pretty close, so it's hard to tell. So that's what you go by, is by the bottoms of them, to see which kind that these guys are. But turret snails are cool. We don't find them very often. I find them fossilized very commonly, and much bigger, like the size of my finger. But this guy is just a cute little example of a little modern one. Just thought he was neat. All right, so what do I want to play and work with? Well, these little Venus, lady in waiting Venuses are really pretty. Pick one with a great pattern and drill a hole in it, maybe. So I'm just gonna set that down here in my lap. What else? Well, I know I definitely like some of these shark's teeth. That one's super cool. That's a nice one. So I think I'll put that here in the pile. I do want to work with this bittersweet and just kind of clean up the edges a little bit on it, just because it's just so pretty. Not so much on the inside, but you know, that's what Dremels are for. Get rid of that junk, no problem. And there was some really nice limpets in here. Look at the size of that guy. He's awesome. So I think I actually might want to make a necklace out of that fella right there. I just really love the size of it. And that oyster will pop right off when I get the Dremel to it, no problem. And I love that little zigzag too. And I have some of them in my collection, so I don't mind making a piece of jewelry out of one of these. They're a rare find, but I mean, that's just gonna look so cool set off with something. Hey, here's an idea. That egg cockle's in really nice shape. And that little guy could sit right in there from a little piece of chain and frame it. Okay, yep, doing that. Totally doing that. What else? This moon snail. He's kind of torn up and beat up. Oh my gosh, there's a limpet stuck in there. Another one. Imagine that. All right, so what is going to happen with him is he's going to get trimmed around the edge and some of that cut off the back, and he'll be made sort of flatter. So I'll work with him too. And you know what? You want to see what the inside of a shell looks like? Let's take this and cut it in half. And maybe this one too. Let's just cut them in half. And so you can see what the inside of the spirals and stuff like that look like, because that's going to be pretty awesome. Put those in my lap. Oh, and absolutely, this is going to get made into some earrings right here. And let's see what else. These big pieces over here. Big piece of apples, crowns. I think, because this one is broken here too, I think I might give him the same treatment. I'll get him cut along the inside so that you've got this beautiful shell on the outside to appreciate, and then you can see the beauty on the inside of it too. That would be sort of neat. All right, keep that. What else? What else? Well, you know I can't resist my colorful little calico scallops. They are my favorites. So I've got some that have some kind of funky stuff going on with them. I'm just going to clean up because I just love their colors. And that pink, that one with that orange stripe. And these guys will make really good pendants once they're cleaned up. And just in the spirit of, you know, making something prettier out of them together, I also have a little orange guy up here And I might mate him up with one of these. And, ooh, some other pretty colored ones too. Look at this black one. Now I have a second one too. Now this is not a natural color for scallops to get, this black color, but man, that's awesome. So yeah, I feel a combo coming on with this black and with this orange and with that purple maybe. I don't know. I'll have to get, once I clean them up, I'll probably decide, but, or it might be nice to put one with a white one and sort of set it off. That would be sort of sweet too. Okay, well, I'm going to pick through this pile a couple more times, pick out a couple other things, then clear this table off, and we'll get to work. So I've got some stuff pulled out that I wanted to work on. These little Venus clams already have holes. So all I'm going to do is make those holes a little bit bigger in those guys. These five of them here. And they're actually going to go in combination into a necklace with this. So those guys just need to make the holes a little bit bigger. Won't take much to do that. And then these little carditas, I have this idea where I want to put them together in one thing, kind of like that. Haven't technically figured it out exactly just yet, but I'm going to put some holes in these edges and get wire through that so that it hangs like fanned out, sort of like that. I don't know. I can see it in my head. I just can't describe it. This guy's gonna get made into some earrings. These are gonna get cut into some hearts. I don't know why I brought this over here. It's really kind of too fragile to work with. So, set that aside. Now the zigzag flat, I actually put it inside this white scallop and I liked it even better than inside the egg cockle. So those guys are gonna go together. And then this pair will go together. I'm gonna put wire wrapping on that tooth and hang it inside, so it's like its own little shrine. That'll be really cool when it's done. And we're gonna cut these in half just to see what's inside of them. Just why not? Let's do it. So we're gonna get these guys in half so you can see the spirals in the insides of them. And then a few other pieces. I'm just gonna drill like this little coquina set that's gonna gather, and these little scallops that's gonna get cleaned up on the edges and drilled holes. And then we'll clean these guys up. See what we've got to work with. I really want to make something out of that big giant limpet right there. And clean the edges up with a bittersweet as well. I just like that fan sort of a pattern it has to it. And we'll just take this little unevenness off the edge and smooth that out and look nice. These guys just getting drill holes for pendants. And this little shell piece too. It's a little broken piece of an arc or a clam or something. It's been surf-worn completely smooth and shiny. So I'm going to hang that with something. Don't know what yet, but something. And then clean up the edges of this little guy. Make a necklace out of him. That is a crab claw, which I thought was really cool too. So I'm going to clean up the top of that and make a pendant from that. And then I had these two pairs of spiny jewel boxes inside on my desk, and they've been meaning to be drilled for earrings, so we'll go ahead and drill those today as well, even though they didn't come from this trip. All right, let's have some fun.
Thank you.
Look at the inside of that. What a beautiful crown conch. Oh my gosh. I'm going to do some more work on the outside of this guy with a brass brush. And then once that's oiled, that ought to be astonishing. Look at that. Spectacular. Oh, these are getting drill holes in them and going on pendants. These guys are awesome. It takes quite a bit to get through them, especially this little one. I had to switch to the diamond as opposed to the sanding bit. But yeah, wow. Really, really love that. The detail inside of that auger. And in the Sereth. I mean, what? Those are so cool. Don't leave me high and dry. Baby, you get me high and fire. You're gentle in wind and rain. You're some kind of butterfly. Baby, you get me feel that you whip up my appetite. everything cut and cleaned for the most part. Now it's time to start drilling some stuff. Oh, that is so pretty. Cleaned up, nice and smooth and wearable. Oh, I love it. I just love it. Such a pretty shark eye. And this guy, man, he's awesome without the oysters on him. So cool. But oh my goodness, these two, I am just in love with that. And this one actually, I'm not sure if you could see that on the camera, where the opening is back behind it, you can sort of see through there. I don't know if you can sort of see that. So I won't even have to drill this. I mean, it's already basically drilled. I'll just put a jump ring through it and hang it on a pendant. I'm just gonna have to scuff it a little bit with a brush or something to get some of that dust stuff out of there. And then the Sereth. Boy, for two shells that don't look all that dissimilar, the insides of them are really, really different. It's just amazing. Oh my gosh, I just love those. So pretty. Okay, so now we got a lot of stuff to drill through. So that's what we're gonna start working on next. Okay, as you can see, everything's drill cut, oiled, and wiped off, and has the findings set out for it. So let's talk about a few of the things here. These big olives in the back and all this big hardware, I'm looking to make keychains out of these guys. So that's what's going to happen with that. These moon snails, seeing these eyelets? We'll talk about those in a second, but I'm doing that to go in the hole so that this won't cut the cord, and a cord can actually pass through the top of the shell. See, there's a hole on one side and there's the hole on the other. And I had to revamp my idea for these guys here, the little carditas that I put the two holes into. There's one of them, there's the second one, the third one's off to the side. Do something different with that. Then I've got this piece of the crown conch, a little couple set, his and hers, of the turkey wings, some of the hearts, some earrings, and these cute little Venus clams that some of them had holes in already, so I just punched a bunch more holes in them, and they're all gonna kind of cascade together. And this is our big tulip that cut into earrings. There's our bittersweet, our zigzag flat, and our shark's tooth are both going inside other shells to sort of frame them, as is the moon snail. I tried a few different things inside of that talon shell and nothing worked until I got to that moon snail, and it fit like perfect. So hopefully that'll hang nicely and work out. And then this, I'm making a little, like an ice cream cone out of it. It's kind of hard to describe, but I wanted to have like this little color pop at the top and then be able to see inside of there. So we'll see how that goes. That's another experiment too. Okay, so remember those really cool carditas that I drilled and I put two holes in three of them, and it was going to make this nice like curvilinear sort of like a wing design? Yeah, that didn't work out. I fought with that thing for like an hour. And it didn't work out. And sometimes that's just the way it goes at the jewelry bench. Sometimes things work, sometimes they don't. As an artist, you have to be ready to try a different idea or two if it doesn't work out. So these aren't going to look like what I planned when I cut and drilled them, but I think I came up with a pretty cool way to do it even still, so. We'll tackle this little Cardita set that I am pairing with a really adorable little gaudy Nautica I got last year down in Marco, which I love. So pretty. And yeah, I was trying to hook the three shells here, here, and here and make them sort of fan out, and that didn't work. So I'm going to try something a little bit different here. What I'm going to do is hook this little gaudy Nautica to the front where that wire is. And that wire is going to get made into the hanger. Oh, I shouldn't have closed that. I need to hook it onto it. Oops. All right now, this wire is loose. It's not pressed down to there. That guy right to there, and then when I tighten that wire, it'll tighten the jump ring up to the front of everything, and it will not go anywhere. All right, so I'm just lightly pulling on that to get it tightened, and now I'm gonna make what's called a wrap loop. So one wire becomes your hanger. Your other wire becomes sort of a wrap. You can see that. They're both in the back of the piece, so it doesn't matter which is which. Do standard wrap loop. Straighten that a little bit. There we go. And you hold your loop. You grasp the end of the wire with some tiny nose pliers. I like round nose for this. And you just bring this working wire around the base wire a couple times. One more, I think. All right, and then see, I have this little tiny piece in the back. I'm gonna bend that in there. So it's kind of catching on the back of the shell. All right, so here's half the loop is basically done. I'm going to take this other wire and we're going to come from the front side, go around this a couple of times, and make a coil. Ooh, that little piece I was bending down in the back didn't go where I wanted it to. It's all right. Fix that when they get this tightened. No problem. All right, now, like we did before, we're coiling again. Only this time I want to use the very small end of the plier to just start a little loop. Hopefully you can see that. Gently work this little coil around through your flat pliers till you get it tightened up. Now that I have that sort of the way I want it, push it up into the middle. Fold the coil down, straighten the loop, And now we tighten the wire so it stays where we want. And this little guy down here, he's our back kind of tab holding this into place. Let's give him a little squeeze. And now everything's locked in. And we have our little pendant on here. And just for fun, I'm gonna put a kink in that wire. And there we go. We have a little wire wrap rib cardita. This one's matched up with a Gaudi Nautica. Put the tighten it up twist in. And there we have another one done. Very cool. Gosh, it looks just like a little orange ice cream cone. That is so cute. Love it. So far, so good. This guy nice and wide. Top of that's kind of deep. Is so cool. Oh, I might have to keep that for myself, man. That's just excellent. I love those two together. Oh, look at that together. That is stunning. That is a shark eye moon snail paired up with fat talon. And it just happens that it just nestles in there perfectly. I love that. So cool. And here we have our little turtles on those tulip shell pieces. Those look great. Love it.
I hope you enjoy part two of this two-part series for Turtle Beach and Caspersen Beach. Just wanted to say thanks for watching and give you a little idea of some of the things that I have coming up that are still in the pipeline and still being worked on. When I first got this camera, I went a little nuts and I went a bunch of places with it right off the bat and shot a lot of extra footage. That ended up being a good thing because we have a really big red tide problem going on right about now. So I haven't really been able to get to too many places, and I had to kind of go out of my way to get to a few spots. So I'm going to be sharing some more video of things that were shot in January and February this month. And a couple of the places that we have been to are Egmont Key, Honeymoon Island, and even a long day trip up to Ancloke Key, actually. So lots more interesting and nifty things to come. Thank you so much for joining the channel. I really appreciate it. And I noticed we have a few people that have come back, almost 1,000, that are returning visitors to watch some of the videos. But I only have about 500 subscribers or so. So I'd just like to invite you to subscribe to the channel so you can get some more cool content like the stuff you've been watching. Also, huge announcement. Almost forgot. I got an online store up. I used my Square and I actually have an online store up. I'm going to go ahead and put the link to it in the description for this so that you can get to it. Once I get to 1,000 subscribers, YouTube will actually let me put links to things right under the video. So you would be able to, once you watch the video, to actually just purchase something right from that screen and never even really have to leave YouTube if you didn't want to. So, if we can get to 1,000 subscribers, that's what's going to be coming next. It's been a really fun journey so far with everybody. Thanks for watching. Please come back again. Thank you.